spring reading for Virgo for 2017. I have changed my layout. I am using different cards, different setup, the whole deal. Now, the cards I'm using four different decks altogether. I split the male and female energies for the readings. And for the masculine energies, I'm using the God and Titans deck. For the feminine energies, I'm using the Goddess and Sirens deck, both by Stacy DeMarco. Now, for clarification cards, I'm using, for the feminines, the Kuan Yin Oracle by Alana Fairchild. And for the masculine side, I'm using the Voices of the Trees deck from Mickey Mueller. So that's what I'm doing. Now, I'm using pyramid spreads. I do not assign individual cards, individual meanings. I just kind of go with the whole picture, a baseline, and it seems like a foundation and where they're headed from there. So that's the way I'm going to go with it. So we start out with the feminine, and we will go from there. The first card for the feminines is, we're talking about Virgo feminines, is self-love. The base here is redemption and reduction. Redemption and reduction and self-love. So, let me get into this energy a little bit here. It seems like the Virgo females have been really getting a greater appreciation for themselves, learning to work on their own self-esteem, I guess, but it's more self-love. I get self-esteem is really internal, but I think self-love is kind of like prettying themselves up, you know, almost like to attract a partner in that way. So the Virgos on the feminine side are really kind of like, how am I viewed, you know, and that's really the essence I get from the card too, is like feeling that power from within, but also beautifying it from without. Redemption, feeling like there's a situation where these Virgo females may be having to come up and over something. They have maybe had a pitfall and may have bruised their ego or self-esteem in that way. And so they are trying to come underneath that and get beyond that. So there might have been, like I said, a pitfall that they've had come across where they are trying to redeem themselves at this point. And then there's a reduction. And I feel like this situation may have been something that happened, an unpleasantry between friends, where you kind of look like an idiot. The woman is standing there going, yeah, you know, da, 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 and being childish or, you know, or something like that. I'm getting a scenario like that, where you blew off on someone in a way that really wasn't very mature of you or in that way. So now you have to redeem yourself, but in the meantime, there's a reduction. So it may be inflicted on you. The reduction may be that, you know, you lost someone because of that. You lost a friendship. You lost a job, maybe even. It could be even a job, but a situation that come at you that you acted like you're kind of a goofball, and there's a reduction because of that. I feel like it was imposed on you, so meaning you didn't do the reducing. The reducing was done to you. So in that way, so I feel like that is, and there's some kind of redemption. You have to kind of redeem yourself again and get back up on the horse, because there's a little bit of a situation where you weren't handling yourself with the utmost whatever, you know, like you weren't being in it. So we have the temptation card and prosperity down the line here. So prosperity really just speaks to being rewarded. So you cannot get rewarded unless you put in the work. So it's like, you know, we have redemption, temptation, and self-love. So there's some things you got to do internally to work on your own qualities, to realize that, you know, you're coming out of self-hate here, and this is what caused the problem in the begin with. Like, you came out and you're not realizing you're going against someone else. You're going, well, I'm not hating myself, I'm hating them. Well, yeah, it is a reflection from your own self. So that's maybe part of that awakening that you may need in that way. It's kind of a wake-up call saying, yeah, it's reflection of you that you hate other people. So it's, it, you cannot hold hate in your own self if you do not carry it. And it's kind of translation there may be lost, but you may be coming across that where you're going to have to work on that. So there may be a temptation to not do that, temptation to not fix that situation, but we'll see. We end up with home. So that's interesting. And when I get a sense of that, it's like, yeah, I'm going to go home where I'm safe and I don't have to deal with this. So I get a sense from these Virgos where they realize what has happened and they see it, but they're kind of not really wanting to fix it at this point. They're not wanting to do the spiritual work that they need to do to flip their situation so that it doesn't come at them again. I think it may come at them a few more times. And I think also they may be tempted to lash out again. There may be the temptation to lash out again, but they, in their better part of who they are, they're kind of like wanting to go home, wanting to, you know, to keep themselves in wraps because they know that that's the wrong thing to do. So there's a wisdom, a sense of wisdom there for the right things, but it's just there's a huge temptation to go in the wrong ways. And it really, the root of it here, self-love. You just have to pay more attention to yourself and appreciate yourself more and then go outward from that, because it's just really, there's a sense of who you are as not being appropriate, and then when someone outside of you comes at you, I feel it's a bit of a squabble here. Someone outside of you comes at you and they say, okay, you know, I don't like this. And then suddenly it's a huge thing because you really are feeling it inside. You're resonating at that and you don't want to admit that. You don't want to show that. So then you lash out at them and then you kind of look like a goof because it's obvious to them. And then after you look at it, it's kind of obvious to you, but you didn't see that when you did, and you kind of let yourself go in a place where you kind of shouldn't have let yourself go, but you did anyway. And now you have to kind of redeem yourself. You have to kind of come up over that hill and see from a higher vantage point where you're just kind of in it. You weren't really seeing out of that. So, and because of that, you might have, you know, caused some, you know, people around you to kind of back up, reduction. I feel like it's not a complete cut. It's just like, I'm not, you know, people are going, I'm not putting up with that. I'm not, you know, this is childish, or this isn't the way things work. So be aware that you might have people really kind of backing off of you in that way for the feminine Virgos. And then the temptation, I feel like you're strong enough to know that to put yourself out of where you will be tempted, but I'm not sure that you will not learn your lesson at this point in that way. I think you were kind of just going, okay, I'm going to retreat instead of putting myself out there where I could deal with this in a productive way. And it's a little harder. It is a little harder to face those issues. It's a little harder to put yourself in the traffic when you know you got to weave and bob. But at the same time, you know, you're knowing that it's not right. So you're doing what you need to do to get yourself out of it. So hopefully that temptation doesn't drive you. And I mean, there's the air of prosperity here. So that just shows that, you know, that you can be redeemed and you have those qualities. You just have to dig a little bit and put a little sweat and effort into, you know, this redeeming yourself. You have to put a little effort, meaning you have to go outward and face those people that, you know, came at you. And you have to deal with that situation, not run from it. Face it and go, yeah, I was an idiot. That's all you have to do, really. And they'll go, yeah, you were, and then it's done. You deal with it, you move on, and it's not, you know, it doesn't create a big hubbub, but it could, it kind of expands if you hide from it. It expands, you know, they're going, oh, da, da, and then they talk. But if you go in there and then you explain, you know, yeah, I was being an idiot, I should have done that. The forgiveness, the ability to get them involved in that, because you have one here and one here, it just grows in both areas and it has the ability. And then if you face them together, it's like, yeah, it's gone. That energy is gone. It's forgiven, it's redeemed, and then you can start back to where you were. So it's like feeling like that kind of an issue, squabbling in a kind of a way, and it's some kind of a social circle where you were in a situation where you just created something that you kind of knew beforehand was not good. And now you're kind of hiding from it because you know that it's wrong, but yet you don't want to get back in the line of fire and start dealing with it because you're just feeling off or whatever. But I don't sense it as a bad thing. I just sense it as, you know, it's wrong, so you just got to take a break. Take your time and kind of get out of the road a little bit so that you can, you know, in the future. And like I said, the prosperity is there. So I think you will come out of that and you will go in the right way. That air is there for you if you indulge in it. If you are tempted by, you know, more chaos, then you can go in that direction as well. I mean, it is equal, but you're hiding in your own home. Like, I'm saying home, but hiding where you feel safe, you know, back away from what that energy, away from the energy that caused the ruckus there. And you kind of need to go right back into it, I think, is my advice to you, would be go right back into it, go, yeah, and admit your defeat. Go, yeah, you know what, I acted like an idiot, and then you dispel it. And you can either go and press in there and regain your, you know, instead of reduction, you can regain. And instead of, you know, and then there's the redemption. It's like, yeah, you know, yeah, you were an idiot, okay? Take your lump and you go. And then there it is, solved. The energy's clear. It's all good, you know? And you don't want it. So right now, I get a heavy sense there's a lot of home base. We're just going to lay back and not enter into that too much because we just need to, you know, it's, you know, we got that feeling, so until we get over that. So hopefully you guys get over that. Now, the clarification card is the Book of Changes. So this may really be on the change of some reductions that you have, maybe to keep you at bay. I mean, I've got to look at these cards as I go here, but the Book of Changes is really about change. So there may have been a blow up there where there was a situation where this person did need to go. But you were being, I still see you as kind of being in the wrong and knowing you're in the wrong. It's just, there's a conflict there beyond of what the actual argument was. I feel the argument was just petty. But the person, you got issues, but it just, you guys aren't solving it with what actually blew up here. That's what I'm feeling, is there's a misdirection in the intent. There's an argument, has nothing to do with the issues, and that, I mean, that happens all the time. So it may be that one, that you are meant to change this relationship in a good degree, and you need to go back in there and admit your wrongs and take your lumps. Or it may be that relationship does need to go, but you still have to face it and say, you know what, I don't like what you do or what you say. And you have to confront that in that way. I don't like what you do, how you deal, where you're going, where you're coming from. I don't like none of it. And I don't want to deal with you anymore. And you just lay that. Lay that down for that person instead of bucking. I feel like there's a bit of bucking energies here. And not quite sure why. But again, feeling like there's something under deeper issues here between the two of them. And I feel like this person is making you see. They're making you see. They're being that mirror that they need to be. But it's still irritating and agitating for the person that's getting it. It's like, ugh. Because it's, and the reason that it fired you up so much was because it is absolutely resonating within you. It is actually there. You cannot deny that. So if you are saying, no, it's not, you are in denial, so you need to go there and look there. And that's the deeper part of it. But the change, so there's a bit of change that needs to happen here. And that is kind of the overview for the whole feminine reading, is that you just have to kind of flow with that and be okay with that there's some changes coming along here. And don't fight them. And maybe if that's the issue, that you're fighting because they're wanting to go, just let it go. Let it be. If you're fighting to keep them, you cannot, you can only do that for so long. They're going to go where they need to go anyway. So you just need to go with the flow. Let that happen, because the universe is really saying, this is the change that needs to happen, and this is what, you know. And if you are in conflict, then you are fighting that in some way, and it is just not within the flow to do that. So that is the feminine. I'm going to get into the masculines here. Little bit of squabbling on the feminine side. So the masculine, the base of what we have, is inventiveness, balance, and wisdom. I feel like these males are very much in a creative phase. Inventiveness, balance, and wisdom. I feel like they're, this may be grounded in work issues, where they have to put their life's work and knowledge into account, and they have to balance some kind and be creative within that. I'm saying inventiveness, creative is a more feminine word, but inventiveness is more like they really have to come up with some ideas and some things that they just, it's not normally in their repertoire, I guess. In the middle here, we have fear and leadership. So there is something that is stirring in these male Virgos that is causing them to, I mean, fear is just brought up to bring the issues. So there's issues coming out here. And the fear is what is bringing it to the forefront. And it may have to do with leadership. Leadership roles that you play, leadership people coming at you in leadership ways, people in authority coming at you and dealing with things. There may be a fear of losing control. You may be the one in control and wanting to keep control. And you may have to listen to a higher power in that way and have some fear attached to that. Yeah, you may be the leader and having to outsource to someone else in that way so that you can move forward here. There's something hitting the fear button having to do with the role that you play in taking upon of others, okay, if I could put it. Now we end up at skill. So this is a very interesting, intricate, it's external, okay, so it's not a lot of inside stuff. This is very external for these Virgos. The males are, I mean, they've got their wisdom, they are very balanced, and they're inventive. They've got all these ideas. And they're showing me like it's all, man, they could solve any situation that they want. So if we look on the one side, we have skill, fear, and inventiveness. So there may be a little bit of fear wrapped up in a challenge of going outside of the box to do something, a challenge of putting yourself in a position that you are just not used to. Not only not used to, doesn't feel right, is not what you subscribe to, okay? So there's fear in coming out and doing things differently. I get a high sense, though, from these males. They know they've got a big barrel to soak from. I know that they've got their reservoir filled, but there is a sense of fear here in what they pull. If I pull this, what's going to happen? There's some kind of, so they're thinking they have to be very, very skillful in how they do this. They have to be very astute, attuned to everything, in tune with everything. They're very hypervigilant about every single step of the way here. But that is kind of, the fear is bringing that out. It's like, okay, I'm going to pay, you know, so much attention to exactly how I do this. Because I've got all these resources, but there's something that's kind of flipped. Now, if we go on the right side, there's skill, leadership, and wisdom. Now, those are huge traits in such a solid, I mean, this is beyond solid. This is prepared to the maximum. Wisdom. So they know what they need to know. They do not need to gain any knowledge here. Leadership. They have the ability. And it is, I get a strong sense from most of these Virgos. They've been using this for some time. And the skill. Well, the skill I feel is a focus from the fear that they are feeling about whatever. It's just a little corner. And I feel like it's really, once it's accomplished, it'll be like, yeah, that wasn't as hard as I thought it was going to be. But they are treating it with kid gloves. They are just going to absolutely load this with every bit of skill, wisdom, and leadership that they have. They are going to wrap it in bubble wrap. And I mean, this thing ain't going to, it ain't going to, this egg is going to be so protected that they're just not going to be able to harm it whatsoever. So I get a sense here, and we have balance in the middle. So these males are very balanced, very focused, know what they need, know what, like these Virgos really got their stuff together.
This is interesting.
Very good energy. They're very potent in what they are in. And I mean, this could be... I'm not really getting a sense of love here. I'm getting strategic. So usually that's in work or life, period. You don't get this kind of focus and skill in the love direction. So it is more having to do with energies that they are dealing with to solve a problem in that way. And though I do not see it as a problem, I see it as part of the flow of what is coming in at them. So it is part of their path that they have to take on. But there's some kind of a twist there. It's just a little bit different than what they've got, because they've dealt with everything, they've had everything, and this just does not fit in that box. It does not fit in that box. But they are balanced, and I mean, they have the balance. The only other thing that I would want in here is peace. And I don't think that they're lacking it. I just think that that would be a complete kit. And I mean, there's nothing that can get through to these people. There's nothing that can rattle them. So for the masculines, a very focused energy, and they are attacking whatever, like, and I don't even get it that it's an overly in an attack sense. I feel like they're approaching this situation with the utmost skill, leadership, and wisdom that they have. And also coming with inventiveness out of there. So they're having to really dip into things that, even though they've been through it all, they just kind of quite, well, this is different. This is different. So they really have to go from a sense of this inventiveness. They got to pull some stuff in here that they're not quite comfortable with. It's not their regular toolbox. This is the one on the shelf. I'm going to open that up. And man, I haven't seen these tools in a while. And I don't know if they're going to work. But, I mean, they know what will work or what won't work. And they're just going to, I mean, they're going to wrap everything so tightly that it's just, it's going to get delivered. And it's going to be safe. And that's it. So, huge sense of complete package here of just really a lot. I mean, skill, leadership, and wisdom. And that is the key to where these men are coming from. And they've got what they need. Now, the clarification card is Broomer Reed. So it's cleansing and vitality. Now we have this woman and she's in front of a hut. And it's indicative of a medicine hut. So she is a healing woman, so these men may have healing energies in mind, or the power where they are trying to help and heal others. And in that, they really have to keep in mind, I don't know if they have to keep in mind, I think they've, like, this is, with the reading, it gives me a sense of, yeah, everything, my house is neat, my house is tidy, I've got, you know, because you have to have a clean house in order to go outward and heal from that. And I feel like that is the air that they have. So for some, you may have to keep in mind that if you do not have a clean house, you know. And I'm getting the sense it's like kind of, you know, throwing stones from a glass house, that kind of idea. But at the same time, I feel like they do have what they need, and they have. And all the supplies are inside. I mean, the herbs are drying on the outside. And she is just doing her diligence, what she needs to do. So having somewhat of a clean slate in order to move. So whatever it is, I feel like they will accomplish here. And I feel like they got the skills and the power and the wisdom, leadership, and skill to do that. They are also quite balanced. I feel like this kind of gives the peace. Actually, this gives me a sense of peace and calm throughout it. We have the abilities to heal here. So if you're feeling, if these men are coming across a situation where this thing out of the blue is something that is going to cause unrest in any way or chaos, I get a sense that that is something that absolutely can be healed. So if there's anything that comes up, any ruckus that comes up, they also have the ability to deal with that as well. And that is what I get a sense of here, is peace and calm and come to me, I'll make it better. You know, and they have everything they need to make it better. All those herbs sitting out there, just all the tools that you need. So that's the reading I get for Virgo. That's very interesting. Because whatever it is, it means a lot to them. It is a deeper issue, I feel. It just a very... very strong in the masculine energy of balance, and I mean, like I said, there's just something that's coming up in fear, and I mean, it's all along. I mean, we got skill, fear, inventiveness. It's all along in the path. Like, I think there's a recognition that there's something that's kind of scary, but it is not really any kind of. I'm saying it's a challenge, but that's even heavy, because it's like, no, I'll just take it in stride. It's I know what I need to do, and I got to do it. That kind of thing. It brings up a little fear, but, there's more than enough balance on this side to deal with that fear. It's just a little bit of fear here, but we got inventiveness, which is a powerful force to bring about good change, good ways. And then the skill, well, that is grounded good ways. So, all good, good ways. So whatever it is these Virgos are after... to solve, they not only will they be pivotal in it, but they will absolutely be. And there may be a hiccup along the way. There may be a hiccup or two, like some maintenance on this. But I mean, you got this. It is nothing. You have all the tools. You will solve. And I do feel like it's a two-part thing. I feel like you're going to go in there and do, and then you lay back a bit, and then there's another bang, and then you're going to go in there, and it's like, that's okay, I got the tools for that as well. It's no sweat. So that's kind of the feeling I get, because this really gives me a sense of peace and calm and healing. It just heals everything. And it may, in fact, heal you more than you think that it has the ability to do so. So whatever you're going, and I feel like these Virgos are going outward with it, and whatever it is that they're trying to help others with is absolutely in tune, going to turn back on them and heal them as well. So, very good. Nice. Good stuff. So, for Virgos, for the spring of 2017, that is the masculine feminine reading. I wanted to continue. I had such great reception with the sexual reading. I wanted to continue with that. But I feel like we have to get into some grounded, deeper issues first. And then we'll go on, maybe in next year I'll go more into the sexual side of things. And whoever's following me, hopefully they grow in that. And then it'll be funner when we get into the sexual side, because then a lot of the issues will be gone. So that's my goal anyway. So I too like the sexual side. I like reading for it because it really does drudge up things. And I have to look at my own readings sometimes. So, but we have to. I think we have to get... more deep into the grounded issues and get rid of those. So hopefully this will illuminate that for not only Virgos but all the signs, and then we can work on having fun next year with the sexual readings, and I think that will be a better place for them. So if you appreciate this, let me know. If not, well, tell someone else. In the meantime, I want to thank you for your likes and subscribes. I appreciate it, all the views. And I sometimes I can't get caught up during the weeks that I make them. These are very hectic for me with the editing process and whatnot. But I'm glad everybody appreciates the cards, and I do as well. So I'm glad for the feedback of that. I will keep that up. So thank you again. This was the reading for Virgos for spring of 2017. Take care and bye. Thank you.